Here we're going to use the idea of similitude and scaling using pi groups to determine ultimately the force on an object. So let's say that we're told that the force on this object is a function of volumetric flow rate, length, density, and gravity. And from that, we're asked to find our dimensionless or pi groups. So we use the Buckingham Pi theorem, and we find that our pi groups, two of them, are F divided by rho G L cubed, which is a function of Q divided by the square root of G times L to the fifth. And given that our volumetric flow rate on our model is 0.01 meters cubed per second, the flow rate for the prototype is 101.2 meters cubed per second, and the length of the prototype is 1,000 meters. And we are asked, what is the length scale? In other words, what is the length of the model to that of the prototype? So, in order to determine that, we need to find the length of the model. So, we look at our two pi groups, and with the information that we're given, we realize that we're going to have to use our second pi group in order to find the length of the model. So Q divided by the square root of G L to the fifth of the model is going to equal Q times the square root of G L to the fifth of the prototype. So we're going to assume that gravity stays constant. So Q times the square root of L to the fifth of the model equals Q divided by the square root of L to the fifth of the prototype. So let's simplify this and try and write it in terms of L of the model. So the Q of the model divided by the Q of the prototype times the square root of the length of the prototype to the fifth equals the square root of the length of the model to the fifth. If we square both sides, we get Q of m divided by Q sub p squared times L length of the prototype to the fifth equals the length of the model to the fifth. And then we just raise them both to the 1/5 to isolate the length of the model. So this is Q of m divided by Q of p to the 2/5 times the length of the prototype is going to be the length of the model. And when we put our numbers in from above, such that 0.01 divided by 101.2, both in meters cubed per second, raised to the 2/5 times 1,000 meters, we end up with the length of the model equals 25 meters. So our scale, which is Lm divided by L sub p, is 25 over 1,000, which equals 1/40. So let's go a little bit further in the same situation, and let's say that we are asked to find the force on the prototype equals what if the force on the model is 3 newtons? And we're going to assume that this is being done in the same fluid. So now we're going to use our second pi group. So force divided by rho g L to the third of the model is going to equal that force rho g L cubed of the prototype. Since it's the same fluid and we assume that gravity is constant, we can write this as that the force of the model equals L cubed of the model, or over L cubed of the model, equals the force of the prototype, L of the prototype cubed. And this is a little confusing, so I'm going to rewrite this as the length of the model cube. So the force on the prototype equals the force on the model times the length of the prototype divided by the length of the model cube. And now you see why we had to use our first dimensionless parameter, because we would not have known what the scale or the scaling of the prototype to the model would be. So let's take a look here. Our force of the prototype equals our force on the model, and our scaling is 40 over 1. That's the inverse of our 1 over 40, because it's L sub P over L sub M. And now we have to cube this. So this equals our 3 newtons times 40 over 1 cubed, and therefore our force on the prototype is 192,000 newtons, or 192 kilonewtons.